Hi, and welcome to this video. In it, we will show you how to set up an NST Audio VMX88L installation processor. The VMX88L can replace at least three key components required in a typical installation. These are the audio matrix, the zone mixer, and the speaker management, or crossover. Typically, these three jobs would be handled by three different pieces of equipment, but they can all be performed by the VMX. We also gain the advantage of less cabling and fewer points of failure, plus full remote control of their functions. Let's look at a typical install in a bar/restaurant and club that might feature several audio zones and require many audio sources. The ability to reconfigure parts of the system for daytime, evening, and night modes is also a requirement. So let's start with the basics. The VMX88L and the remote control connection on a network. We'll need a network router or switch. The one shown here is a small 8-port switch which supports power over Ethernet. More on that later. We connect the Ethernet port on the rear of the VMX to a switch, and let's go straight to Wi-Fi and connect the switch to a Wi-Fi access point. You could, of course, have a cabled connection from the switch into a PC or a laptop. This can be a Windows PC or Mac-based machine. Our remote software, DNet, is available for both, and for iPad. We will assume that DNet is already installed on a computer, and we will just go online now to check we are connected. Press the online button to begin locating all devices on the network. Great! The VMX has appeared in the rack, and has a green light to show all is well. It's worth knowing you could choose to go online and send settings from a file. This allows you to configure a system offline or off-site. Now, let's add some sources. We'll start with some mono sources that would typically be used in a daytime or early evening setting. Let's add a laptop or tablet that might be used for background music from Spotify. This device could also be used to control the system via Wi-Fi if DNet is installed on it. Now, let's add it to the DNet configuration. It's on input 1, so we'll click Inputs at the top, and then double-click on input 1, and name it. Let's continue with a couple of different audio sources from video. A beIN sports cable receiver. And a satellite TV receiver. We'll add them to channels 2 and 3 in DNet in the same way. Lastly, for the mono sources, we'll add an input for connecting a roaming or guest source, such as a mobile phone or a Bluetooth adapter. It's connected on channel 4 of our VMX. Next, we'll add a couple of stereo sources. The only difference between mono and stereo sources is that we are going to connect them to two inputs at a time, and we will link the controls in DNet so both channels always track when adjusted. So, let's go ahead and add a DJ mixer to channels 5 and 6. In DNet, it's good practice to link the channels before any adjustments are made, so we can guarantee both are identical. Click on the Routing Wizard button top right and select the Links tab. Then, tick the box next to Input 5, under the Input 6 column, to link 5 and 6. Back on the input screen, move the fader for either linked channel, and confirm they both track. We'll add a second DJ mixer in the same way, on inputs 7 and 8. And lastly, link and name the inputs in DNet. Okay, so we are done with all the inputs. Let's turn our attention to the speakers, and the various zones we might require in the venue. We'll start with creating four zones of ceiling speakers or small wall speakers. Each zone is mono. So, we will create a foyer zone, an above the bar zone, a restaurant zone, plus one for the VIP area. Now, we'll add these to the first four outputs of our VMX configuration in DNet, and label them. We'll also quickly add the high-pass filter to all four zones to roll off the bass a little, and give the speakers more headroom. So, outputs labeled, now click on the first output's EQ, and introduce the high pass filter. We will just choose an arbitrary value for now. You'll need to check the usable response of your speakers, and set this accordingly. If all of these four zones are using the same speaker model, we can quickly use copy and paste to copy the first output settings, and paste it into the next three, like this. Now, to complement the daytime ceiling speakers, we will add a couple of small subs on a single output. Label it, and then add a complementary low-pass filter to this output to remove the HF content. In this way, we've utilized the crossover functionality of the VMX. There is also lots of additional EQ, plus high-performance two-stage limiters, which we would recommend you use to protect the system from abuse and unnecessary callouts. For more info on setting up limiters, have a read through our tech library documents. We're nearly at the end now. Let's set up the dance floor system with a stereo pair of outputs for the top cabinets, and a single output for the dance floor subs. These are configured in exactly the same way as we just did for the daytime speaker system. The only thing to remember is to link the stereo outputs for the top cabinets, before adding any crossover settings. Okay, here we go. So we are done. We now have a complete system with four mono and two stereo sources, and multiple output zones. Four mono ones, plus subs, for the daytime, and a stereo one, plus bigger subs, for the dance floor. If we quickly flip to the matrix screen, we can see that everything is there. All that's left to do is choose which inputs feed which zones. For example, we would want the two DJ mixes to feed their stereo dance floor outputs left and right, but some to mono for the sub. The rest of the configuration works the same way. Because we took the time to label all the inputs and outputs, using the VMX matrix feature is now as simple as dialing in the levels from each input to each output zone. Lastly, if we flip back to the output screen, there's the zone mixer right there, with mutes and level faders for every part of the venue. One final thing, to keep all these settings out of the hands of those that shouldn't have them, it's wise to lock the unit with a pin, and consider adding VR1 remote panels. These neat power over Ethernet wall panels are configured within DNet, allowing end users to adjust parts of the system. For example, presets for daytime, evening, and nighttime configurations, or maybe swapping sources to speakers and level controls for different zones. Multiple VR1s can coexist on the network for use in different parts of the venue, programmed to do different things. The VIP area could have its own one, as could the foyer or behind the bar. There's a series of 90-second training videos about how to set up a VR1 on the website or on our YouTube channel. Just search YouTube for NST VR1. Thanks for watching, and remember, our support is only an email or phone call away.